In the early hours of July 31, 1992, Thai Airways Flight 311 began its journey, unbeknownst to all of the impending disaster. On this fateful day, the Airbus A310, a twin-engine aircraft, was ready for its regular flight, bridging the gap between two vibrant cities, Bangkok, the heart of Thailand, and Kathmandu, the capital of Nepal. Aboard this flight were 213 souls, each one a story in itself. There were passengers traveling for leisure, business, and those returning home. There were families, solo travelers, and couples, a microcosm of society encapsulated within the confines of this aircraft. Alongside them was a dedicated crew of 14, led by an experienced captain, all prepared to ensure a smooth and comfortable journey for their passengers. The atmosphere was filled with a sense of routine, a hum of activity as the aircraft prepared for departure. The engines roared to life, the safety instructions were relayed, and seatbelts clicked into place. As the aircraft taxied down the runway, the familiar sensation of takeoff was felt by all on board. The ground fell away, the city lights became a distant twinkle, and the star-studded sky welcomed the ascending aircraft. In the cockpit, the pilots navigated the plane into the vast expanse of the night sky. Their voices echoed with calm professionalism, their hands moved with practiced ease over the controls. There was no hint of the catastrophe that was about to befall them. On board, passengers settled into their seats, the cabin lights dimmed, and conversations dwindled to a murmur. Some passengers drifted off to sleep, some lost themselves in books or music, while others stared out into the infinite darkness beyond their windows. As the flight reached cruising altitude, everyone settled in, unaware of the tragedy that was about to unfold. The flight was seemingly uneventful. The passengers relaxed, the crew efficiently going about their duties. The aircraft was humming along, a microcosm of life high above the clouds. The cabin was filled with the familiar sounds of a journey in progress. The soft murmuring of conversations, the rustle of turning magazine pages, the intermittent ding of the service bell. In the cockpit, the pilot and co-pilot were engaged in their routine checks, the hum of the engines, the soft glow of the dashboard lights, the steady beep of the instruments, all were like a symphony to their ears. A testament to the machine's flawless functioning. They were kings of the skies, commanding an airborne castle, their every move dictated by the rhythm of the flight. Meanwhile, the cabin crew was a picture of efficiency. They moved up and down the aisle, their hands deftly performing the dance of service. They poured drinks, served meals, and attended to passengers with the ease of seasoned professionals. Their smiles never faded, their patience never waned. They were the unsung heroes of the flight, ensuring a smooth journey for all on board. Among the passengers, there was a sense of calm. Some were engrossed in their books or devices, others were chatting with their companions, while a few were catching a few winks before their destination. Each one was cocooned in their own bubble, oblivious to the intricate ballet of operations that was keeping them aloft. But beneath this veneer of normalcy, something else was brewing. The aircraft was like a swan, serene on the surface but paddling furiously beneath. The pilot's eyes were growing increasingly focused, their hands moving with a sense of urgency. The cabin crew's smiles were just a tad too strained, their movements a touch too hurried. As the flight approached its final hour, a sense of unease started to creep in. The calm was slowly giving way to the storm, the tranquility was about to be shattered, but for now, the passengers and crew were blissfully unaware of the turmoil that lay ahead. The flight was still a picture of serenity, a calm before the storm. A sudden jerk, a drop in altitude, and an eerie silence filled the cabin, the first signs of the impending disaster. In this moment, the world as they knew it began to shift. The humdrum of the in-flight service was abruptly interrupted. The clinking of cutlery ceased, the murmur of conversations muted. The aircraft, once a symbol of human achievement, now became a harbinger of doom. The initial signs of trouble were subtle yet undeniable. The slight tremor of the wings, the flickering of cabin lights, the dip in the flight path. The collective heartbeat of the passengers quickened, their breaths held hostage by uncertainty. Like a Greek chorus, the seatbelt sign chimed in, a glaring red warning in the face of growing fear. The crew, trained to be the comforting constant in the unpredictable skies, found their smiles wavering, yet, they held their composure, their professionalism a beacon in the fog of panic. All eyes turned to the cockpit, the throne of the pilot, the commander of their fate, The pilot, bearing the weight of hundreds of lives on his shoulders, grappled with the controls. His hands, steady and experienced, danced over dials and switches, a ballet of desperation and determination. His mind raced, processing countless scenarios, calculating odds, formulating strategies. The tension in the cabin grew, thick and palpable, a storm of silent prayers and whispered goodbyes. Children clung to their parents, strangers held hands, united in their shared vulnerability. The plane, once a vessel of dreams and destinations, was now a crucible of chaos. Yet, amidst the bedlam, a voice emerged, steady as a lighthouse in a turbulent sea. The pilot's voice, imbued with years of training and countless hours in the sky, echoed through the cabin. His words, carefully chosen, promised safety, a beacon of hope in the heart of the tempest. Amidst the chaos, the pilot's calm voice echoed through the cabin, promising a safe landing. Despite the pilot's best efforts, the inevitable could not be avoided. Flight 311 was going down. The final moments of Thai Airlines Flight 311 were a chilling testament to the harsh realities of air travel. The cockpit, once a place of controlled calm, was now a scene of frantic desperation. The pilot, a seasoned veteran with countless hours of flight under his belt, was faced with the unthinkable. His aircraft, a mechanical marvel of the skies, was hurtling towards the earth with an unstoppable force. The pilot's hands, trained and steady, grappled with the controls, fighting against the spiraling descent. The plane, a vessel of human innovation, reduced to a metal bird with broken wings, was unresponsive. The alarms echoed through the cockpit, a symphony of warning signals that painted a grim picture of the impending doom. Yet, amidst the chaos, the pilot stood resolute. His voice, strained but steady, echoed through the cabin. "Brace for impact." His words, a testament to his commitment to his passengers' safety till the very end. The plane was now a mere speck in the vast expanse of the sky, plummeting towards the rugged terrains of Nepal. The pilot, despite the imminent threat, tried to navigate the aircraft away from populated areas. Every decision, every maneuver, was a desperate attempt to minimize the damage, to save as many lives as possible. The final seconds were a blur. The ground rushed up to meet them, the noise was deafening, and then, silence. The inevitable had arrived. Flight 311 had crashed. The impact was catastrophic, reducing the once majestic bird of the skies to a mangled wreckage. The crash site, a grim reminder of the tragedy, was nestled amidst the mountainous terrains of Nepal. The once serene landscape was now marred by the debris of the crash plane, a stark contrast to the untouched beauty that surrounded it. Flight 311 crashed into the mountainous terrains of Nepal, marking one of the deadliest aviation disasters in history.